PT. The thoughts and opinions expressed are those of the sponsors and don't necessarily reflect those of this station or iHeartMedia.
Well, it's noontime, and two boys from Brooklyn want to serve you a huge portion of humor for lunch. So, let's break out the lunch pail. Or the sandwich you packed. Les, Don, and Freddy S. bring you jokes and nostalgia mixed in with some important information about medicine, food, dating, or just the stuff you need to help that bagel go down nice and smooth. And if you have a story about anything you want to share, a bad date, a movie review, or just a strange thing that happened to you at work, call in and join the fun toll-free at 1-800-889-0267 right now. So, sit back and let's start the lunch break. Les, Don, and Freddy S. are ready to go. So here are the boys from Brooklyn and Don.
Uh-oh. Guess what day it is?
Guess what day it is? Huh? Anybody?
Julie, hey, guess what day it is?
Oh, come on, I know you can hear me.
Mike. What day is it, Mike? Leslie, guess what today is?
It's hump day.
Woo-hoo!
It's a party up in here.
It's a party.
Hey! Good afternoon, South Florida, Boca. Boca?
Boca, Atlanta, Chicago, New York, L.A., San Francisco, and soon to be Houston.
That's right. You can catch us live on Facebook.
We are live streaming on Facebook on Amp2 TV Productions. We are also shared on Two Boys from Brooklyn. We are on Periscope at Amp2 TV Productions.
I hope we're on Periscope. Gio, if you listen
Gio,
to me,
are we on Periscope? We are also on Twitter, hashtag number two, Boys from Brooklyn, and we are on Instagram, hashtag Two Boys from Brooklyn. Whew, we're everywhere.
Whew, is right.
And at 12:07, I'm good. We are out there.
We are out
there. What time
there is
it? 12:08.
12:08, yes.
Are you going to do the weather?
Do you know what? I really should have a green screen, but honestly, it's so beautiful
what's
out
what's
today.
What's wrong with your speech then?
A green screen? Green screen? It's beautiful outside. You know what? It's just being able to see you.
Oh, yeah, right.
That's what it is.
I love it. Somebody get me some boots. Listen, that show we had yesterday was outstanding.
It was an amazing show we had yesterday with Les and Renee and Sarah Spiritual.
That was outstanding.
It was a great show. It was a full set.
And we are live and everything's working.
Whew. You know what happened yesterday? Sitting in that chair next to Sarah, I'm thinking I'm getting very cold and I had angel bumps the whole show. So
oh, yeah?
When we go to break, she said, I know, I'm really sorry. She said, I saw you were so cold. She said, I tried to keep the energy from really being here. She said, I pulled the energy back. She said, but I knew that was going to happen.
Wow.
And so she knew, and I was sitting there thinking the whole time I was so cold.
That's amazing.
Dawn.
Yes. I know, because I'm not very dressed either, so I'm cold. Is that what you're going to say?
You're always going to be cold.
How did I know what you were going to say?
And number two, you're just cold. I mean, you're cold in 98-degree weather.
It wasn't the same, though. It was these angel bumps the whole time.
Angel bumps.
And she was doodling and drawing and doing her thing.
What's an angel bump look like?
It's like a goose.
That's like chicken skin.
It's like chicken skin, but chicken skin doesn't sound very feminine.
They call it chicken skin.
But angel bumps, right?
You know what, Dawn? It's
when we were growing up in the Bronx, we called it angel skin,
right? That's
right.
That's Bronx people. Yeah, chicken skin. We don't have the same kind of class.
There were no angels on my back in
them days. It's confirmation, Dawn.
I got the shivers.
Because I hang out with Sarah outside of here, and I get the same way where I'm like, ooh, I'm feeling the
right, the energies.
Yes.
She waves her hand, the computer goes out, the lights blink. We're up and running today, though.
I know.
I'm going to tell you what freaked me out.
What?
She held her hand over
Renee's hand.
Uh-huh.
And Renee went, holy smokes, what is going on?
Really?
Yeah.
Well, she was showing her, because Renee showed her a picture of her touching a patient's hand. And was Renee holding her patient's hand. So Sarah says, let me show you this. The energy is in your hand. And you don't even have to touch. She goes like this.
And
you
got
can
them
just
bumps.
Feel the power. I have it again. You can just feel the energy coming between the hands without even the full touch.
She's taught us that. It's that's amazing. Reiki. It's and then you can play with it. It's like silly putty.
Yeah.
It's crazy,
and
right?
It's amazing.
You know, if you sprinkle salt on it, you'll see a blue light.
This is so far beyond my scope of understanding.
Is that true?
Well, what did I do yesterday? Didn't I show you something yesterday?
What did you show me?
With the hand?
Yes, but I didn't sprinkle salt on it.
No, if you sprinkle salt in the hand and you do, you'll see a blue light. And
let's
you know
try that.
Am I moving on?
Let's try
no,
that.
Yeah, I'm visualizing. To teach people something and nothing happens.
I'm visualizing having two hands doing this and trying to sprinkle the salt at the same time.
No, you put hand on your palm. What is it? Okay, that's it.
Explain.
That's it. That's it.
No, no, no.
The sign
put your hand
goes
in your pocket.
Up.
Put your hand over the top of my hand.
That's right.
Let's see.
You now
the
we
energy?
Take another hand and we put some salt on
it. There you go.
It.
Do you feel it?
And no.
Do you feel the heat? Seriously.
Yeah, Freddy.
You take the salt.
Freddy, you can feel the heat here.
You take the salt and you put it on.
I don't,
you don't feel it coming between the hands?
Listen, don't do that because my equipment is very sensitive. I already had Sarah come in here and blow it up. You know what? And the lights were flickering.
Finally on a Wednesday, we're up on air. It took 3 days.
God,
yeah,
I mean, you don't know.
Goodness.
Unbelievable.
I know. And it's hump day. It's a wacky Wednesday.
It's a wacky Wednesday.
Oh, big news, though.
Big news.
Breaking news.
Breaking news.
Two broads from Boca.
Don't say it yet.
Is on tonight.
That's it. So you can say, I haven't gotten confirmation.
We don't have confirmation yet, but we could potentially have big news tonight on your FM dial.
I already blew it up all
Maybe.
Over the place.
It's okay.
It'll happen.
Okay.
Confirmation doesn't mean that it's not going to happen. It just, I would be feeling a lot better if I knew it was happening.
It's supposed to be happening. Big news. Two broads from Boca tonight. We have Andrea Cohen, family mediator, on 1470 AM, at 7 to 7:30 tonight.
That's your get guess?
Yes. Family mediation, divorce. She's a guardian ad litem. All for the kids.
Very cool. And hopefully tonight it'll be on 95.3 FM.
Oh, there you go.
If I don't say the room, if you feel the tension.
Yes.
So do you like the shirt, the Michelle Debsey Productions?
Behind you?
It's behind me.
The room has never looked better.
You can't see, it's over there.
Oh, I haven't seen it.
But she brought me a used shirt. I don't want to say nothing. It has makeup.
It's wrinkled and it has makeup on it.
It has makeup.
I wanted it to have makeup.
It's authentic.
It
has some. It has some unidentifiable stains.
I let my daughter put it on this morning.
Maybe she should sign it.
It has soup stains.
Don't complain, because when you go to the Hard Rock and you look at all that gear and all that stuff on the walls, that's been used.
Connecticut just compared me to Hard Rock.
There
so
you go.
I'll take it. Thank nice. You.
I compared you to a rock. But anyway, I asked her for this shirt for the Women's Expo.
Uh-huh.
So guess what she does?
What?
Her husband comes wearing my shirt. And he's wearing it.
Well,
and he looked great in it.
It's her husband.
Yeah. So I said, you're wearing my shirt. That's what I tell him. He says, you want me to take this off? I said, oh, no. Oh, no. So, I get... That's
I
this
haven't
is the baby
the
shirt, right? You took
yeah.
the shirt off the
when
baby?
When was the expo? 3 weeks ago?
Yeah.
3 weeks.
Yeah, I haven't heard the end of the freaking shirt yet.
And you're not
so
going to. Is that your daughter's shirt?
That was going to be.
It was going to be?
You know
so
what?
You're giving me your
I
daughter's shirt.
I took the shirt off my
now
daughter's
guilt,
back for
she
you.
She took the
now
shirt off her back for you.
You know what? I'm not giving it back anymore.
I'd like to see that. I'd like to see you try that shirt on. As a matter of fact, the bet we had going from last Wednesday, that you and I were swapping clothes.
Oh, that's right. Yes.
That was the bet.
That I want to see.
That was the bet.
No clothes.
Yeah.
Listen,
yes.
Drink your coffee.
That was the bet.
That was our bet last Wednesday.
No, but I won the bet.
What did we even bet, by the way? What was even the deal? I don't even know.
I think it was for Halloween.
But we had another one going yesterday.
We have
bagel making in bikinis.
That's what we're going to be doing in remote.
We're doing a remote.
Oh, my God.
Bagel making in bikinis.
At what bagel
oh!
store?
Oh! Can we announce that?
We can potentially announce it.
No, let's do it.
Do it.
What the hell?
Do it.
Oh, what boy. You do is your sponsor.
This is what mimosas do to people. Go ahead.
No, this is a true story. No,
Brooklyn what mimosa. You mean the orange?
Brooklyn Water Bagels.
I'm smelling.
Brooklyn Water Bagels.
The
soon
Brooklyn
to
Cafe.
Be the Brooklyn Cafe. Brooklyn Water Bagels.
Brooklyn Water Bagels is coming.
So when
to
we
the
go
side.
Remote at Brooklyn Water Bagels, we're making bagels in bikinis. I don't know if you can wear bikinis.
I don't know what she's talking about, but the big news.
I'll be wearing a bikini. You not
you know
so
that
sure.
you
not
are so
much.
You are so cut off. The bottom line here is that Brooklyn Bagel is they have 6 stores.
I know.
Now, do we go to Vero Beach?
Does
our
I don't think so.
The best one is downtown Fort Lauderdale.
There's one at Miami International Airport. Did you know that?
All right, wait a minute. Follow the bouncing ball.
Okay.
Don't we go up to
how
Vero?
Far does our feed go?
It goes to Vero down to North Miami.
You'd have to ask Ken. I don't know.
Yes,
yeah,
we need to
Vero
talk to
Beach
Ken.
Is the Treasure Coast, right?
Yes.
All right, listen. If you are in Vero Beach, I want you
Josh,
to call.
Okay, Josh, listen up.
800-889-0267.
If
and tell
us,
you can hear us. And
you
we'll give you a
gonna
bagel.
Do? We're going to call Brooklyn Water Bagels in Vero. See if they can hear us.
They have 6 stores that they want us to do remotes from. We're going to start at Vero and work our way down to Boca.
Do you know, I spoke with the owner a few years ago when they opened in Del Rey, and I said, there are no good bagel places in Costa Rica. I need to open one of
a Brooklyn Water Bagel. And yes. It's all about the water.
I know.
It's about the iconic water and being in Brooklyn. And what better sponsor for Brooklyn Cafe than to be a Brooklyn Water Bagel?
This is why doing a show with women is like...
That's why
the best thing that ever happened to you,
Freddie. That's why you love going to work every day.
This is like a whale dead in the ocean.
Come on.
I bring in the big news and what happens? I get nothing. I get South America.
You know what Freddie gets? That's a lie.
Wait.
Every Tuesday night.
Who brought
you
the big news?
You, but
thank you.
We're not jumping up and down like we should be. We're talking about everything else.
Every Tuesday night,
we're cautiously
Dawn,
optimistic.
And I'm sure it's the same on Wednesday when you walk into Beasley. You walk into Freddie's little office, and he's surrounded
by
ladies.
That's not my office. That's a radio room.
No, Wednesday nights aren't like that.
Tuesday. Well,
you guys
the best,
rock Tuesday.
The best
Wednesdays
for Tuesday, I walk in. This has happened like 5 weeks in a row now. Everybody gets up and knows that I get my seat right next to Freddie, right? Mm. Last night, that lady just stood there. I was like, you get
to sit. That was Maddie.
No, that was not Maddie. That was Dr. Whoever was next to you. She was like, please.
Plastic surgeon.
Everybody knows I get the throne next to Freddie.
It's like going to see The Godfather.
That's exactly
Michelle
what it
has
is.
Thrown next to you. That's nice.
I gotta tell you something.
Freddie made me an offer I couldn't refuse.
Bring me a bagel and put it next to me.
The maker of dreams.
He's my Willy Wonka. That's what
you know.
I
the
say.
Funny
exactly.
thing, my
golden
funny thing
ticket.
Is
look
that
at
her
shirt.
Two guests
You're the golden
were wackier than any other people. The doctors you talked about,
even more than Dr. Wacky. I think your guest might be Dr. Wacky if she's listening.
Yeah, I think so, too.
I don't know what you're talking about at all.
Dr. Wacky's a lady that she knows. She brought her here. She was, like,
is
so
her
nervous.
Name Dr. Wacky?
No, she was talking 100 miles a minute.
We don't identify, her real name.
I don't know her name.
I know you
so
don't.
So I said... I
only
said,
she knows who
I said, are you
about.
A doctor? She says, yeah. I says, you're Dr. Wacky. She never talked to me again.
Would love to know what Freddie says behind my back, but I wouldn't. I don't want to know.
You don't
just keep
know.
Telling me the nice things you tell me.
You don't want to know. But anyway, shall we move into... our guest.
So big news, right?
Yes.
Very exciting.
Very exciting.
Oh, now it's too late. It's done.
It's too late.
It's done.
Why
dead in the water.
Poo-poo everything? You poo-poo everything.
No, I didn't poo-poo nothing.
Freddie is like wet sand in my underpants.
Yeah, do you know what it is?
Can't get it out of there.
It's getting...
Hold on a second. Let's get back to this wet sand in my underpants. You like that too?
No.
You put a little bit of oil on that?
Do you know what that? You know what wet sand in your panties is?
Going somewhere.
No, itchy and annoying.
Itchy, yes. Annoying it? As... Yes.
It's nothing nice.
Guys love sand in there.
Well, yeah, you're not a girl.
Pure irritation.
I know, but guys like it.
Thank you. It is a pure irritation is what
right,
she's saying.
What started.
So maybe
it's
not
like
a compliment.
Sponge. It cleans. It's cleansing.
It's definitely exfoliating.
It's like an exfoliator. Exactly.
There you go.
No more coffee for you.
You see? You see what I tell you? Uh-huh. You give me the yin, I give you the yang.
No more coffee for this one over here.
No, you're the one we're cutting off. All right, so shall we?
How's that going for you?
Do you have anything else? Anything else?
As is that.
Anything else? Breaking
this is
news.
A wacky
yes, as
show.
A matter of fact, you have 3 more days for early voting. So please go out and do
what?
Your due diligence. Saturday is the end of early voting.
So what?
People should go out and vote for whomever they choose, but choose. Make a choice.
I did so Sunday.
Don't let other people choose for you. Step up and empower yourself
to
make a voice.
It's all about the choices.
Go to the library.
Exactly. Do you like that segue, Jason? It's all about the choice.
Nicely done.
You go to the library to vote, or wherever your precinct is.
You're going to go today in your spare time.
You got to look it up. You got to find out where your precinct is. I usually vote in my...
Why? Go to jail?
No. They're not all open.
They're not all
open. That's
official,
what we call...
Yeah. That's what
from the Bronx.
New York, right?
Yeah, this is the New York thing.
Hey, you remember the precinct, right? You want to see off your phone now?
Okay, sorry.
Because I usually vote at my complex's clubhouse, but that precinct is not open, so I had to go to the library.
Last time I went to the 44 precinct, they stole my bike.
Of course they...
Your bike. And you were,
I was
what, 12? 8.
Yeah. Jeez. Stole my bike. I went to play for the Bronx Giants football team.
I feel so violated.
One day we need to get your mom and dad on the phone. My mom and dad are busy commenting on Facebook, so you translate.
What do you want me to say?
Are they still in the Bronx?
Yeah, the Bronx of Puerto Rico.
Oh, they're Puerto Rico. Okay.
They don't speak English?
They do, but she's not.
We need to validate the Freddy stories.
I will. I'll do it.
Oh, absolutely.
Carol wants to validate the Freddy stories. She's going to call Mamacita.
I'll ask.
I tell you what, Juju was with me, my cousin.
Juju. Juju. Yes, of course it is.
His real name is Abdulia. How you get Juju from that? Abdulia was with me. Check this out. Abdulia was with me. They stole our bikes. He could have gotten away because he was behind me.
Yes.
But he didn't want to leave me, so they stole his bike, too. It was four guys from South Florida.
And how old is Juju? How old was he?
Juju was 11. So Juju's brother belonged to the Ghetto Brothers gang.
Carol, I can't even.
In the Bronx. So Juju runs to get his brother. And you should see, it was 100 guys coming Juju. Looking for these guys.
If you're from the Bronx, you know somebody named Juju, Jojo. There's always somebody like that in the crew.
Juju's real name was Abdulio, so how do you get Juju from Abdulio?
Okay, well now, if you have your bike stolen down here, you have someone who can get it for you.
How? Can you get my bike?
Can you get bikes?
Sure. Sure, what do you need?
This was over 30 years ago.
Do you know Coco Crisp, too, from the team? Coco Crisp?
He's from the Cleveland Indians. Coco Crisp?
Coco Crisp. God bless him.
He played for Boston.
God bless. Coco Crisp.
Yeah. That's all I got to say. Good cereal.
Do you know why Cocoa they call crispy. Him that?
No.
That's exactly what it was. When he was crispy. A baby, his mother just fed him that crap.
Oh, God.
But that's his
they
real name.
They need the Eco Baby Food Lady.
It was good back in the day.
Heather? Duncan?
No, we spoke to Heather yesterday. No, the lady we the had on Lizzie's Organic.
Miles,
I spoke to Heather
Jennifer
yesterday.
Miles.
Yes.
She's going to be on...
Jennifer Miles will be sponsoring the Monday. Eco Baby.
On Community Connections? Good. Maybe I'll
You're
come and
put it on Monday.
I'll come
maybe.
Watch.
No, you should.
Okay.
Take notes and bring a tiger.
Okay.
Bring
I just got off the phone with Heather Duncan, though, and that expo is another expo I'm getting involved with in some capacity.
Fabulous. So are we.
Are you broadcasting from there?
We are working
and
on
is
that.
And it's at the convention center,
yes.
too. Yeah.
We are
this
working
is
on that as we
home.
Speak. That's what we
Yay.
Think.
Yay.
We
right.
travel in packs. It's right. the AmTV TV production pack.
Can we introduce our
we
guests?
We need shirts, by the way.
Do I not count as a guest anymore
the
at this
pack.
Point?
No, you're the producer. You're not even supposed to be on the air.
Oh, all right. Well,
now
here
you're
I
on
am.
The air.
Thank you.
And we heard it from you.
Uh-huh.
You want to introduce your guest?
Producer. Sure. We have our guest.
You
want
to
talk
into
the mic?
We have our guest, Jason Katz, here today.
You want to look in the camera? Is this the first time on the air?
That's Michelle's is... first time on air.
Mm-hmm. First time on air?
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Take it away, guest.
We have Jason Katz from Choice Foundation with us, and it's all about the children and making choices.
I'm sorry. Are you a ventriloquist? Because she's talking, but I swear I can see your mouth moving.
Do you know why?
With the intro.
I'm helping.
Oh.
No, you just did it. You did it a lot
Because you are so
than
busy
me.
Chit-chatting, we do need to get to our guests.
I feel like a tennis ball right now.
Welcome to our
ladies.
World.
Hi.
Bing
yes.
bong.
Hi. Yes.
We're never having orange juice.
I happen to yeah. like tennis, so it's all right.
No
it's
more
okay.
orange juice.
All right, who are we introducing?
Not me. I'm
Jason
Katz. I'm just
Katz
here to celebrate.
From Choice Foundation.
Hi. How
Welcome,
are you?
Jason. And Michelle is the producer on having Jason with us, so
That's
thank
right.
you
Michelle?
For bringing
thank
him
you.
Forward.
Yes, thank you.
I'm now a producer. I can add that to my
Michelle
long list.
Michelle Dempsey Productions.
Michelle Dempsey Productions. Right There's there. No more room on my LinkedIn to add another title.
Create a new
I tried.
One.
Gets busier.
I have to, it's a hot mess up in there. But
it's busy. It's all good, though.
I'm happy to have the titles.
You know, I wish you hadn't said that.
It's a hot
really,
mess?
Up in India.
Oh,
I
good.
I haven't heard that in so many years. That's a New York thing.
That is such a New York thing, but that's why we're in love.
Oh, God.
That is... That
Jason,
was...
how are you, my friend?
I'm doing well,
I gotta
thank
get
you.
Away from that subject.
It's very I'm entertaining. I'm enjoying listening.
Are you?
Yes, absolutely.
You're
Jason,
are you a watcher?
I am a watcher. Yeah, I'm a doer and a watcher.
You're all cut off. Jason, tell us about the Choice Foundation.
Lord.
Choice Foundation is a passion of mine. Started in 2011. And after about 22 years of training, I felt I needed to get to those that couldn't afford our services.
What type of training?
Personal training and nutrition and life coaching, motivational speaking, helping people to realize their true potential. And then helping them to get there. I facilitate that. I don't actually make them get there. It's all about leading them there and showing them the way, and then they could take over. So that led me to Choice. And Choice, to me, stands for collectively helping our inner city evolve. Inner city just meaning underprivileged, under-resourced children, and families, for that matter. So when I thought of it, I said, how can I get to them? And creating a foundation, a nonprofit foundation, where everybody is a winner. So everybody can, people who donate, they could take their tax write-off and know that their money's going to a good cause. The foundation receives the money and is able to turn it over and teach the children how to get healthy. And the children get to receive it for free. So it's a win-win all around. It brings the kids up to where they should be in life. And should be in life to me means that they learn the right way to eat, the right way to exercise, to love each other, not to hate each other, to have respect for one another.
Changing
and
the culture.
Themselves. Exactly.
How long has the foundation been around?
I started in 2011, and our Our goal is to reach the world and to get everybody to realize their true potential.
For the kids and families you work with. So you go into different schools, different facilities.
Yes, we work. We collaborate a lot with a lot of different foundations. And we work together. I help all of their children that they service. And different schools, Pompano Beach Middle is a great school. Lauderdale Lakes Middle, great school. And numerous others. We love getting in there and teaching them how to just take care of themselves. And I love watching their eyes open up when I express to them the kind of love that I have for what I'm doing. They appreciate that a whole lot more. And
so you work with them on food. And the big thing people always come back to is healthy food costs more money. So you're looking at inner city schools, inner city children based on your demographics that you described, low socioeconomics. And you were talking about healthy food,
right.
Healthy lifestyles. Everyone's working. You've got two families working, two parents working, two caregivers. Sometimes the kids are working.
Correct.
How do you promote healthy eating on a budget? How do you teach them what to do with that?
It's a great question. The way that I do it personally is I relate it to their lives immediately. So usually the kids will bring a soda, a juice box, a bag of potato chips, a candy
lunch.
Bar, something. And I express them. I ask them how much did that cost?
Lunch in the Bronx.
Exactly, right?
Lunch in the Bronx.
It's a quick fix, but it's not a healthy fix.
Roll up.
And so these children are taught the wrong way. So I said, how much did that bag of chips cost you? They say $1. I said, you know what you could do with that dollar? You can go to Publix or Winn-Dixie or Walmart or Target or any one of these food stores, and you can get food that'll feed you for two meals for $1. And they're like, what are you talking about? That doesn't make any sense. And I say, well, a pound of chicken breast is about $1.50. So that's not even organic. Organic is about $3.50. So yes, it does cost more to go organic. And so I try to help them, if they're having a tight budget, then they can do certain organics, such as vegetables and fruits. And if they can't afford the meat right away, then you know they'll be able to work on that down the road. But you got to start small and build big.
But if they can make choices,
exactly.
Back to choices.
Back to choice. I have a question about the name.
I got a couple of questions.
Can I ask just one?
I love all these questions. One at a time, though, please.
Did you develop the acronym after you picked the word? Or did you have the words in place and then they just
That's a great question.
Choice?
I came up with the word.
What came first, the chicken or the egg?
Well, for me, I mean, I've been helping. I've trained more than 9,000 people and one-on-one. So when it comes to choices, it's all about the choices that you make.
So the word came
always.
First.
The word came first, okay. And then on my way to Alaska with my father, we go fishing every summer. I came up with the acronym, and then I wrote the seminars as well.
I love that.
It's.
I'm a sucker for acronyms.
I can see that.
Oh yeah.
Acronyms are good.
It's always
Using
about the choice.
It is about the choice. It just feels so good to make good choices.
I got a different question. You sure. When you reach out for these kids, now we have aren't we doing something in November with
yes,
children?
Yes, next Friday. We have Kids in Distress coming for DJ for the day, and the following week we have ADL coming with some kids on for Thanksgiving.
So we do stuff with kids as well. Okay, I saw something on 60 Minutes where there was a team in Washington, a league. They couldn't play baseball because they didn't have any equipment. So there's a new app now out, and I can't remember the name of it, but you know, when your children stop playing, like my kids stop playing ball, what do you do with the equipment and the shoes and the cleats and the uniforms and all that? So everybody is donating it into these warehouses. And the kids, I mean, they get it cleaned and everything else, and you polish it, and it's good as new.
Wonderful.
Whatever you don't need, you know I give to the Prestige Club.
But this is what I think using your ideology of what you're using, it will lend itself to inner-city kids. I mean, I'm an inner-city kid.
And look at you.
And you're just perfect.
I grew up in Spanish Harlem.
And now you're up in Spanish Harlem, Carol.
I did. I was in the South Bronx.
Yes. Okay.
But then all of that disappeared. So we had to run like the rats. And then my parents moved me to
Cousin Juju.
Spanish Harlem.
Where did you? And Juju?
Juju down the block.
Juju was
with us. Running down the block to Spanish Harlem.
Hey, listen, Juju, if you're listening in Puerto Rico, my friend, call in because they don't believe your name.
1-800-889-0267. Let's text Juju and have him give us a call.
I can do that.
Juju.
Hey, Juju. But I learned all of that stuff. But with your organization, I'm thinking maybe we go and we start bringing stuff.
That's excellent.
Excellent. That idea.
And you know, this is the time of year, and we just passed Halloween, so now Christmas is around the corner. Hanukkah's around the corner.
Thanksgiving
is right there. Yeah. So let's do this. I mean, this is the time
Absolutely.
To really look and say it's not all about Thanksgiving at the food. Let's give back. Let's make these holidays special for the kids. Clean up, you know, donate, go through your stuff, clean it. Let's get them donated. I know last year I went through my son's bike and so many things. Absolutely. Were just one of our local elementary schools. And the outpouring and the kids, the special needs, the autism program, they were just so grateful because these kids are, not only are they autistic, but they were abused and physically, emotionally, and everyone comes to it with so many issues. A red bicycle? Oh my goodness.
Yeah. It's a great way to give back.
A doll from Target. Amazing.
That's right. So if you want to participate in this venture with Jason,
can we give you? How about call you?
Call Dempsey Productions.
Call Dempsey Productions.
What's your phone number, Dempsey Productions?
911-305-469-7500.
Oh,
I'm now a radio producer.
So that, those were little pencils.
305-469-7500. Also, you have to plug me and Jenna's, Dr. Jenna's event.
We'll do about that after
for the
our
kids.
Break.
It's for the kids. Are we going to break?
In a minute.
Okay.
Let's just get your number out there, get you a little nervous. Are we going to break?
Yeah.
Are we calling?
You're calling Pinozo.
You want me to?
Yes,
yeah,
please.
Right.
I won't press the buttons.
Yeah, don't.
All right, listen. So it's 1-800-889-0267.
Juju, give us a call. If you have questions for Jason Katz and Choice Foundation, Dempsey Productions, or even this crazy man over here,
give us a call.
We'll be right back.
Please welcome a new sponsor to the show. It's AMP2 TV, the first and only internet network that's truly plugged in. When you're looking for a full-service internet television production company, discover AMP2 TV, a full-service production company that can provide all streaming. Seminars, a sophisticated advertising agency with over 40 years in the ad business. What makes Health and Wealth different from other agencies is they fit your product into the public's need. They help put together the strategy of your business before you commit thousands of dollars and just find out those ideas just don't work. Health and Wealth seminars carry advertising contracts, radio and television contracts, and even a production service contract that will cover all of your business needs. Call today 954-303-9563 and let Health and Wealth seminars carry your business to the next level. The number is 954-303-9563. And remember that what happens when you don't advertise is nothing. Sleep and discover what's holding you back. Call 561-923-8833. DexaFit is conveniently located at 2499 Glades Road in Boca Raton. For more information, contact them at boca@dexafit.com or schedule an appointment online at dexafit.com. Identify your health risks and optimize longevity and fitness. Call 561-923-8833 and mention this ad for special pricing.
Is your child's tablet time greater than engaged activity time? Are you seeking better wellness strategies for your family? Do you want to redefine what your family's quality time looks like? At New Dawn Health Solutions, we focus on the four pillars of health coaching: lifestyle, exercise, attitude, and nutrition to create a balanced approach to wellness. Together, we will open the conversation with you and your children on ways to empower healthy eating, increase physical activity, and set goals. Let's talk about the issues that are important to your family's health. Give New Dawn Health Solutions a call at 561-901-2854 or email us at dawn@newdawnhealthsolutions.com.
You're lunching with two boys from Brooklyn who invite you to advertise on the show. Share your good news. Just call 866-224-5422 and get all the information. There are plenty of options, and this could be a great chance to get the word out about your business or service. That's 866-224-5422. Now let's get back to those two boys from Brooklyn.
Be careful what you wish for.
Foundation.
I will.
Hey,
we're
back.
Got a lot of chit-chat going on.
I don't know. I hit the button early. Sorry.
Nice. You're done.
Nice. Good job.
Holy smokes.
Happy Wednesday, everybody.
Wacky
we
Wednesday.
Are back.
Happy
Jason,
Wednesday.
What's your
It's
mom's
a wacky Wednesday.
Diane Polakoff.
It is wacky
Diane?
Wednesday.
Diane Polakoff. If you're
Dr.
listening.
Diane Polakoff.
Dr. Diane Polakoff, if you're listening, we will let him give out his phone number, I promise. But first.
And we are not going to talk
first,
over each other.
But first, I must show this picture.
Is that him?
Yes.
Good Lord Almighty.
Okay. We have a call. We have Heather Duncan on the phone from Eco Baby Expo.
Hello, Heather.
Hey, how you doing? I just kind of tuned in, and I wanted to say hello.
Hey, girl, hey.
See how we all roll together?
Hey,
welcome to the madness.
Welcome to the Brooklyn Cafe.
I got a heads up on the madness. Sounds like you guys are having a good time in the studio today.
We always have a good time. That is what we do.
Well, that's good.
You know, you follow us at Women's Expo between me and Michelle and Boomy and Alexa and Ro, and can we just keep going? Name everybody.
And I had lunch with Heather last week. We had lunch at Gigi's Waterfront with our group that Heather joins, our little networking group, which was awesome, and that's where we officially met. But Heather, I think you said you saw me at the Expo.
I did. I saw your
I felt like J-Lo. She was like, oh my God, you were the girl from the Expo. And I saw and I was like, I was mortified by my language, but I had stayed up the whole night before watching Tony Robbins, because everybody knows Tony Robbins is the daddy, and I love him, the daddy of all daddies. I watched him all night the night before. I didn't sleep. I was like all hyped up with this crazy energy, and I went in there with a really dirty mouth, and people loved it, my mom. Sorry, Mom.
But I had spies in the room.
You had spies? Who were your spies?
People came out and told me you made people cry.
Yeah, people were crying. There were
tears.
Well,
how do I know that if I
I'm known for that, Freddie.
I'm telling you.
Well, you should have been there.
Heather, tell us about your event.
So, yeah, the Eco Baby Expo is coming up. It's actually going to be in the same location as the Women's Empowerment Expo.
Broward County Convention Center?
Yep.
Our new second home.
On February 11th, correct?
February 11th, that's it is. Just basically, we're kind of
that's Jason's mom's birthday.
Empowering families to make better decisions for their families, and yeah, so it's going to be a great time. And it's not your average baby show. We are definitely going to make it fun and exciting, and have a lot of interactive things.
And then, Boomy's going to be your DJ, correct? You've got about 100 vendors.
Yeah, Boomy is going to be our DJ. Boomy's amazing. Love you.
100 vendors, great speakers, and if you've got the Women Empower Expo peeps on board, you're good to
We've
go.
We've all got your back, Heather.
Amp 2, we're all going.
Oh, awesome. Yay!
All right, so people can find you, Heather, at ecobabyexpo.com, correct?
Yep, ecobabyexpo.com.
Fabulous. Thank you so much for calling. Keep watching.
Of course.
Bye, Heather.
Have a great day.
So long.
Thanks. Bye.
All right, Jason, we need to make Mommy happy. Mom, it's all about the moms, always.
Yes, my mom's
the
best.
How can people find you for your personal training? You also do CPR?
Yep, we have a life-saving company, correct. So, we teach CPR and first aid and OSHA HIV, and we do all the certifications, have been doing it for over 18 years.
What is your phone number or your website?
Our website is www.choice-foundation.org.
And they can find all of your services there?
Find most of my services there. And you can also call us at 954-921-1007. 954-921-1007.
Okay, Freddie, back to this picture, please.
Yes.
Take that card home and leave it on your kitchen counter.
I'm going to put that card on my effing mirror.
Please. Yeah. This card we're going to give to Connecticut to put on her mirror. So, ladies, you need to call Jason. He can coach you.
I can get you into great shape, ladies and gentlemen, bodybuilding, for competitions, whatever.
Do you know what? You do bodybuilding competition work also?
I was Mr. Florida in 1997 Supernatural.
So we have a fabulous company we work with that does metabolic composition and body fat analysis.
Okay.
Called DexaFit.
Excellent.
They're one of our sponsors. So let's make the connection between
That'd
you
be
and
great.
DexaFit. So I went and I did the scan, the analysis, and they do your whole body fat more than BMI. So they look at every limb, your gynoid.
Oh, you told us about that,
your
Freddie.
Stomach area. Look at every
your
fat ratio. Can you guys please stop chit-chatting?
Okay, sorry.
I'm interviewing. Thank you. And getting your body to the next level.
That's it. Okay.
Excellent. That's what I do. I get you to the next level.
So you can do the body fat analysis. You can see where you are, and then
100%. I work with your nutrition. I created an eating plan for you. And help you to get to where you want to be naturally, without any kind of enhancements. I don't believe in enhancements. When it's the drugs.
Well, I just saw something on actually AMP2's Facebook feed that says something like that. You work and you give up your health, but when your health goes, you lose your money that you just gave up your health for to go back to that.
That's it.
Which is life, and it's an unfortunate cyclical thing.
It's your choices. And every choice we make, every single day, all day long, we make hundreds and thousands of choices.
Yeah.
Right.
So it's just making the right ones that you think you can make. And someone said to me, if it feels right in your gut, do it. If it feels that funky, I don't know.
That's it. Thank you.
Don't do it.
And most people think know the difference. It. They just choose the wrong way, though.
Exactly.
They make the wrong choices. Everybody I know is dehydrated. People are perpetually dehydrated.
How much water should you be drinking?
A person should be drinking individually half their body weight in ounces. And then you have to add extra water for your exercises. If you work out for an hour, it's another 16 ounces. If you have alcohol, so an ounce of alcohol, liquor, vodka, whatever, you need another 8 ounces of water.
And how about coffee? Coffee's dehydrating also.
Anything with caffeine in it. So an ounce for ounce. If you've got a 10-ounce cup of coffee this morning, you need 10 ounces of water on top of your minimum, which is half your body weight in ounces.
So hear that, half your body weight in ounces of water, and then add ounce for ounce. Now this is where our math skills come in.
Well, ounce for ounce with caffeine.
Or alcohol.
Well, alcohol, if it's a shot, if it's liquor, it's 1 ounce of liquor for 8 ounces of water.
Ooh,
if it's a beer or
eight
a wine,
times.
If it's beer or wine, it's ounce for ounce.
Just keep drinking water.
I know, they had me.
You know what?
Just keep drinking water. It's that health coaching thing we
listen,
do.
Listen, it's very simple. It's very simple. You want to live. You want to keep cancer away from your body. Cancer grows and thrives in acidic environments.
True.
And if you're dehydrated, you're acidic. And so if you're acidic, you're looking to get cancer. And that's why more people today, because of obviously the studying and everything else that they can, the tests, they are getting cancer left and right. And if you want to kill it, you need to become alkaline.
Mm-hmm.
Your body can't be in an acidic state.
I heard that.
Body balance, alkaline.
Well, there are lots of books out there, and there's lots of different methodologies. My personal methodology is do everything in moderation and always take care of the simple things, such as your water intake, your rest, and your exercise. Those are the simple things, because you don't need a gym to work out.
Correct.
So that's one of the things we teach with Choice, is to teach the children you don't need a membership at a gym to work out. You don't need to go and spend tons of money on food. You go to Burger King or one of these fast food restaurants, and you're spending $6 to $12.
Don't look at me.
And you can stop doing that by going to the store and getting the food. You can even get pre-made food at the store. And it's a whole lot less money, and you know something of what's going into it.
And then you're checking your salt, sodium levels, and
the
sugar.
Fat content, sugar and the
fat.
Sugar. See, people, sugar is astronomical, and that's a major cause of cancer growing in a person's body, because cancer loves sugar. It's easy to metabolize. So it grabs it, it burns it. So they've got all this great energy. The cancer does, and it grows and it thrives.
It keeps growing.
So you got to stop. There's certain things, you know, medication. So I believe medical science has come astronomically in large, you know, leaps and bounds. But when it comes to your health, you can cure your diseases naturally. You don't need the medications. And
so
I've
many
seen
people say that.
I've seen people get rid of AIDS without any drugs, all natural. I change the way they live and their lifestyle. They want to change, they change, and they get rid of it. People with cancer, they get rid of their cancer too naturally.
Making those choices.
That's right, 100%.
So your Choice Foundation, the money goes where?
It goes directly into the foundation so that we can go and we can service the community by teaching them about how to eat right, how to exercise the right way, motivating them to get off their tush and give back to society and not take so much from what they're getting in life. Because we give, we give, we give, they take, they get less and less involved in helping people. So
we have a call. We've got DJ Boomy on the phone.
Yes! Excellent.
Hey, Boomy, how are you?
Oh, my gosh, Boomy.
Welcome to the Brooklyn Cafe.
Welcome, welcome.
How are you, Divas? How are you?
We're fabulous. How are you?
I'm well. I just wanted to chime in really quick to say hello to you guys. I'm watching the show, and I'm really enjoying watching Jason. Jason, you are a hunk, by the way. Can I tell you that? And
Boomy, did you really see that picture?
Okay?
You want her card. I know.
I want my card. Okay. Thank you. I appreciate that.
But you must tell me how you bodybuilding. I actually tried bodybuilding like years ago. I entered into the Pompano Coast Championships in 91.
Excellent.
And I came in third place in the women's lightweight division. Now, keep in mind, I don't have the body that I used to have, okay, at all. But how was it for you in 97?
Well, I always kept myself at about a 5 or 6% body fat. So for me, it took 2 weeks to get down to 3%. And so it wasn't really difficult. But thankfully, I have good genetics. But with people who don't have good genetics, I teach them about their genetics and what they can do to change it. So you can literally change your cellular body by doing things differently.
They say genetics are only 30%. You can. So if you got 70% choice, correct, free will, mm-hmm, to change those genetics.
And you can change the 30% because it's 70%. It's right, so much more overpowering.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, so it's. I appreciate that.
Boomy's going
to
be on next week.
I definitely need to get your information. And Don, I'm looking forward to being on the show with you guys on next week, November 10th.
It's going to be fabulous.
And Michelle, I wanted to say hello to you.
Hi, baby girl. How are you? I miss you already.
It's like a big love fest. Jason, how can Boomy find you again?
You can find me at www.circleoflifesaving.com for my training, great, nutrition, motivation. For Choice, if you want to be involved in Choice Foundation, we love it. Volunteers, donations at www.choice-foundation.org or 954-921-1007. Thanks, you guys.
Great. Awesome. Thank you.
Thanks,
so much,
Boomy,
you guys.
Keep watching.
Bye, can you have a great show?
Take
thank
care.
You. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you all.
Very cool.
Do you know what I envision now? You know the Partridge Family? You know the bus?
This is us. We need a bus.
You know, we got to be dancing.
Do you know the bus? And then there's the mom and the dad. Birds?
I don't know where you're going with
the Partridge
this, okay,
Family.
Yeah,
you're like
the Partridge Family.
You're the bus with the bird, and you've
I'm
got all these little chickadees.
Oh, the bothering you.
The Partridge. You say you're taking us all
on the ride.
You are the leader.
You come up with on the bus.
You're the leader
you're
of
like
the bus.
The lead chicken.
Holy. He's still my Willy Wonka.
The
Wonka.
It's
every
exactly. Bird. Are
the
they
partridge.
Birds?
They're partridges.
They're partridges.
They're birds. Yes, partridges. You are the lead bird. No,
you're
not.
You're the big bird. You remember Sesame Street?
I am the big bird.
Here we go.
Then you're Snuffleupagus.
All right. You and I are the mom. And dad birds.
Oh, now we're birds.
And we got all of our little chickadees following
we're the,
us.
We're the band.
On the bus going, where are we going?
We are going next. Very nice. We're going to BioLife. We're going to the Eco Baby Summit. We're going.
You are so
big
going
time.
To a lot of places.
We're going to the Women's Expo in D.C.
Yeah, we're going,
in Washington.
Right.
We're
oh,
the band.
Next.
We are the band. You're the band leader, and you're driving
the bus.
Oh, Alexa, be up
he's
the studio.
He's a conductor, essentially,
that's
right?
It. Uh-huh.
You're up there going. Dun, 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 dun.
That's
yeah,
it.
Your mom see you do that.
So I have a question. You deal with customers that are worth millions of dollars. You
millions.
Say? How about someone that's worth tens of dollars?
I deal with every customer
no
that needs the help.
Clients
see, the
of
funny
all?
Thing is, clients of all. You know, what's funny is that the millionaires that I train
uh-huh.
don't donate.
Oh.
They don't want to let go of their money.
Of course not.
And so that's the wrong kind of people. That's one of the other reasons why I started Choice Foundation.
Nice.
Because I had to get away from the people who didn't truly care about themselves. I want to help people who want to help themselves.
Awesome.
And if you don't want to help yourselves, then don't spend your money to hire somebody to help you. Because if you're not willing to listen, don't waste your money or the trainer's time or the coach's time or whomever.
And there's so many simple choices you can start with if funds are... not hundreds of millions of dollars.
Absolutely.
Start with your water intake.
Right.
And start with getting off the couch and then call Jason and say, all right, I'm working on the water.
Well, you got to get off the couch.
Well, you can go to my website.
Go to his website while you're on the couch.
On my website, I've got a ton of free information on my website that I put on there on Choice Foundation. So choice-foundation.org. You can go to the advice page, and there's tons of naturopathic things you could do. Exercises, food, healthy. You want to gain health because you're sick for this reason or your kid is sick. I've got remedies for you that are just all naturopathic.
What's one of your favorite naturopathic?
Ginger.
Mine
ginger
too.
Root.
I love ginger.
For inflammation?
Ginger. And most people don't realize that you need to actually cook the ginger
yeah,
in order to get the full benefit.
Delicious.
So what I've learned and what I do is I take ginger root, organic ginger root, because it's like $2 a pound. It's
yeah.
not expensive unless
true.
You go somewhere else in a lot of places.
$2 a pound.
$2 a pound. And you get the root, you wash it, and then you stick it into a blender and you puree it down with water.
Yep.
Now you pour it into a giant vat in a big spaghetti pot and you boil it for an hour. And then you drink it as tea. And then I take the ginger
love
puree
uh-huh.
and I dehydrate it with honey.
Ooh,
organic
delicious.
Raw honey. I mix it
wow.
together, then I dehydrate it and make ginger chews.
This
so.
Guy carries honey sticks around with him.
Oh my
I
God,
do.
I love it.
Yep,
I love ginger. I live by ginger.
Ginger's so what is
great.
The advantage to ginger?
So ginger is amazing because I know people who it's gotten rid of their ulcers in their stomach. Who have any kind of bronchial issue, sinusitis, it helps to diffuse that. It kills bacteria, kills viruses, all the things that I've learned about ginger.
It's good for singers.
It's good for singers, helps with their throat.
Yeah.
It's got a nice warm feel, too, because what it does is it increases your inner core temperature. So if a person has high blood pressure, I tell them limit one cup a day. Because it will raise your blood pressure slightly. Yeah. So if you drink 3 ounces here and 4 ounces there and whatever, then you're fine. But if you don't have any heart issues, drink a couple glasses a day and your inflammation throughout your body diminishes.
All your itises diminish.
Exactly.
But that's what happened. I knew somebody who used to boil that, and then they used to put it with honey.
Yep.
And used to drink it as a tea.
Absolutely.
My
so
blood
good.
Pressure went through the roof.
Now, do you peel
yours?
You
drank too much of it.
Do you peel it?
I don't.
You do
the
not.
The skin is great. You just
no,
wash
just,
it off, get the dirt off of it.
And boil the
me too. I love it.
Yeah, but I used to slice it and then boil it, but you know what? You get so much more when you puree it.
So true.
When you puree it, you're putting all of it into it.
Ginger chews. I need to show the shirt, though, so also, before we run out of time.
No,
very
yeah.
nice.
That is cool. All right,
that
listen.
Nice.
Choice Bikers, wait.
We started Choice Bikers. So we do have a biker organization, so where we ride to raise money for Choice Foundation. So if you want to be part of Choice Bikers, you have a motorcycle of any kind, you can be part of that, too. Just let us know.
Well, I got a show that I produce. We'll talk about that later.
Absolutely.
But before that, let's talk about... You got
well,
a
you
want to
promote a couple things. Yep.
We have, with Dr. Jenna, who you know, you've had on the show.
Dr. Jenna!
Also part of the
Dr.
Expo.
Jenna!
Dr. Jenna! Thursday, November 17th, Treat Yourself by Michelle Dempsey and Dr. Jenna. All the proceeds are going back to the Pace Center for Girls. We're both very active on the board, on the steering committee for Pace, and... I'm very committed to helping those girls. I love them. I love everything about what Pace is doing. So if you want to donate to our raffle, in which the proceeds will go back to Pace, let us know. Call me, once again, 305-469-7500. Thursday, November 10th, I have an event with the Aventura Marketing Council.
What's for that?
That's a business event. If you want to learn about how to grow your business through content marketing, come and check us out. This Friday at Precision Skin Institute, we're doing a VIP event for BioPel. Have you heard of BioPel? Growth factors?
Interesting.
You would, yeah. So we're doing that Friday at 5:30, and I'm having a giant birthday celebration this month.
Is it your birthday?
Well, my party's December 2nd, but my birthday's November 28th, so Louis Bossy's December 2nd. Everybody come down. Also, any gifts, any donations will go back to Pace.
Fabulous.
And
oh,
I donated
nice.
Three personal training sessions to that raffle.
Did you?
Oh, Connecticut, you must be there then.
Connecticut's coming. Connecticut's going to win all three.
Remind me. I want to look fabulous.
Look at her and all her empowerment now.
Oh, yeah. Right?
Good.
Like, and it's also, you know, but anyway.
Monkey juice and making a powder every day of the week.
But it's, you know, I'll be 46. I got to look fabulous.
Exactly. I'm hitting 50 soon. Ooh.
I can't believe that.
Just wait till that party.
Let's go. Let's do it.
It's going to be right here.
Is it?
50,000 balloons
in this
studio.
One room.
They'll love you for that.
Got to start collecting now, Freddie.
Ken Harris, we're talking to you.
Got to bring in... No, I know what I'm going to do. You do your birthday here, I know what I'm going to do.
Rent that camel. Here. Rent that camel you want.
No, I ain't renting the camel, but I know what I'm going to do. And people better not get mad at me.
We're going to put a pole in.
So like I said, I'll put you a pole. They may have had three poles.
There's already half. There's half of one
there's
right now.
There's half a pole I can hang from that one right there.
That's what happened to the pole.
The hey, I forgot to tell you that one of my main collaborations is with a company called Street Waves, and we teach inner city children and families how to surf. So we work hand in hand together.
Oh, wow.
So Street Waves, the founder is Maui Goodbeer, and he's amazing in all of what he does.
That's awesome. That's
really
cool.
Wow, some really good stuff. All right, get in
this
touch.
This guy's
going
to have fans.
Get in touch with Jason, Pace Foundation, Dempsey Productions.
That's
awesome.
Right, call Dempsey. Bombard her phone. Let's see who...
The Partridge Family Bus.
I'm fielding
bus.
All the calls to Freddie.
The AMP2 TV bus is getting
Jason.
Ready to take off.
AMP2
We're getting
TV
ready to
bus.
Go on a road trip. AMP2 TV Productions bus. Gio, we need a bus.
And that picture, that banner has to be on the side of the bus. It has to be wrapped.
We're
in
gonna wrap that.
We have a company to wrap. Eco Graphics is amazing.
There you go.
His number. Well,
I will.
We should buy like an old van.
The Partridge Family Bus. See, you thought
That'd
I was kidding.
I'll drive.
I can visualize it.
I'll drive.
Do you know, you want to hear something crazy?
Do you know what?
You want to hear something? My father can't drive anymore. And he has a van in Puerto Rico. He says, do you want it?
Oh, there you go.
Now and it has no windows.
Does
put
it
on
air
a
conditioning?
Ship.
No.
Forget it. No windows and no air conditioning.
1980 van.
Forget
this one?
About it.
I'll
put
know.
An AC out the back.
All right.
Do the Puerto Rican thing.
Right, you know what time
ceiling.
It is?
It's time to go. Listen, guys, thank you for coming
thank
on.
Thank you, Michelle. Thank you, Jason.
Thank you so much.
Great
That's
show.
So
great
thank
show.
Thank you, Carol. It's time to wrap it up.
Okay, get in trouble.
Happy Wednesday.
Au
put
voila.
Your lunch away. Have a wonderful day. Two broads from Boca tonight, 7 o'clock, tomorrow? 1470. Tomorrow we have Kendra and Sarah Spiritual.
Oh, Kendra, don't miss that.
Tune in. Write this number down, 800-889-0267, and give Sarah a call.
We got music and spiritual Sarah.
Next 2 days.
Very cool. Don't be late.
Have a beautiful week. We'll talk to you later.
Talk to you later.
Bye-bye.
Later.
about it for today's lunch break with two boys from Brooklyn. You're invited to join the break every day, Monday through Friday at 12 noon. So, if you missed some of the good stuff they served up today, there's more coming next time. Bring your lunch and the boys from Brooklyn will bring the smiles. And it's all live. See you next time. Now, go and enjoy the rest of your day.
WBZT West Palm Beach, an iHeartRadio station.